Hi there, Raam here once again. If I had to coach CXOs, leaders, and mom and pop business owners, or Olympic athletes, and someone gives me just 10 minutes to coach them on leadership, here's what I would teach them. It's a framework that I just wrote on a piece of paper here. And this is what I did during my 45-minute flight with the CEO of a very famous organization in this world. He's managing close to 10,000 people under him. It's a multinational organization, MNC organization. And when we were on this flight for 45 minutes, he asked me, like, Raam, teach me in 10 minutes. I'll give you 10 minutes to teach me something that I have not learned at Harvard or any other organization, any other university. There are so many other programs out there, so many other books out there. Tell me something that I can actually use and implement today. Then I will sign you as my coach for the next 5 years. That was the contract. And here's what I did for him during this flight. And this is, some of you may know, some of you have studied psychology. Now, this is a confidence-competence loop. These two things represent confidence and competence. But there's a third angle to it, third dimension to it, which I call it as C. I will tell you what C represents. But first, the confidence-competence loop, is something that tells you when competence goes up, when you start building your skills, your competence goes up and your confidence also goes up along the way. The corollary is also true. When confidence goes up, you start trying newer and newer things and you gain competence in things that you are doing in your activities, in your work, for example. However, we have also seen there are so many people who are both confident and competent but still are not leading at higher and sustained levels of performance. The reason was this. This C stands for courage. When you fuel confidence and competence with courage, your efficiency and productivity and growth grows to a whole new level. And today, especially with respect to leadership in this context, let me share my few thoughts on confidence, competence, and courage. This quick session is also going to be structured this way. I'm going to define what it is for you in this context, in your context, and I'm also going to give you a question that you can ask each day. This is how I have structured my coaching as well, my coaching program as well. I'm a certified coach. I coach on transforming people. I coach on helping. I know that all of you are already extraordinary. I help people become even more extraordinary, go to a whole new level in their performance and growth and habits. So I'm going to give you a definition of all of these three concepts, plus also a question to ask every day that will help you increase all of these three elements in your life. Plus, I'm also going to share with you a habit that you can start, a good habit that you can start implementing today. Right? Let's go ahead. The first thing that you have to learn about confidence in this context is you have to understand that confidence is a feeling. It's a kind of a feeling that you know when you are going to face a challenge. Even before you overcome this challenge, you have that feeling, you get that feeling like, yes, I'm going to face this challenge. I know it's going to be tough, but I'll figure it out. I know there's a way. This positive outlook that you have before you face these challenges, that is what is confidence in leadership positions. And here's a question that you can ask every day to help you increase your confidence to a whole new level. Hope this is visible to you. And the question that you will ask every day is, am I owning my decision? What do I mean by that? When you start owning decisions, which means taking more responsibility, then your confidence goes up. And people will start seeing you as a person of responsibility, and then they will start giving you more and more responsibility. And what happens with more responsibility? Good old Spider-Man story. Responsibility comes with more power and vice versa. More power means more responsibility. So when you start taking more responsibility and when you start owning your decisions, like without, finding faults with others, enabling your, without giving or taking credit for your decisions, plus also taking credit for the results, means owning your decision. When you start owning your decisions, your confidence goes up. And a habit that you have to follow every day to increase the confidence that you may have is open up and move. In positive psychology, it's a very well-known fact that your posture plays a very important role in confidence. When you sit upright, just doing this one small thing, sitting upright and balancing your form can give you confidence. It's also a well-known fact that salespeople who are on the phone all the day, they are usually trained to stand up and talk so that they can exhibit, even on audio, even just on the phone, they can still come across as confident, just standing up and speaking. So posture is going to be a very important part of increasing the confidence, and along with the mindset part, which is like thinking about the positive outcome, also moving up every hour, set an alarm on your mobile phone if you have. Of course, you have your mobile phone, don't you? Everybody has one nowadays. So set an alarm on your phone to buzz off every hour so that you get up and start moving around a little bit. You just stand up, find your balance, find your center, and then sit back. So that will, over a period of time, this is a habit. You start doing, practicing this habit every day. Over a period of time, you'll be even more confident than you already are. Now, coming to the second C of this framework, the second C stands for competence. So what exactly is competence? The competence, if I have to give you a good definition, competence is all about doing things efficiently. Let me give you an example. When you first started tying your shoelace, when you were a kid, when you started tying your shoelace, you had to give a lot of attention to that. You did wrong, you did right, and then ended up in a unbreakable knot sometimes. It happens to all of us, right? And now once you have understood and mastered how to tie a shoelace, today you can tie your shoelace without even thinking about it, without even looking at it, talking to something, doing something. You can watch your TV and still tie your shoelace. You don't need to actually give that attention that you need to give in order to tie a shoelace, right? Very similar to learning how to drive. In the beginning, you had to give all the attention. You get anxious, you're holding the steering wheel so hard, so tight, these things happen. But today, you can speak on the phone, which I do not advise, but still people do that, right? They're speaking on the phone, they're speaking to people inside the cabin, inside your car. And you can also listen to music. You can listen to podcasts while you're driving. You don't have to have the same kind of attention that you used to give when you were learning how to drive. That's my point. So what competence means here in this context is finding ways to increase the efficiency of what you do. So one question that you need to ask every day to increase your competence is this: is there a better way to do this? Whatever you're trying to do today, tomorrow, the week after, ask this question each and every morning or before each and every decision that you make. Is there a better way to do this? So when you start finding consciously better ways to do certain things over a period of time, what happens? Voila, your competence goes up. And what happens when your competence goes up? Your confidence goes up as well. And now this brings us to the habit. Oh, this is a question and this is the habit every day. In order to increase your competence, here's what you do. Learn a new skill. So basic, so important, but very few people do that. But highly productive people, high achievers around the world are known for this. Whether they are in their early ages or whether they are in their, in their 80s and 90s even perhaps. So people who are highly efficient, who are highly competent, they can increase their competitive levels by learning something new. Make up a point, learn a new language, go join a dance class, do a salsa, whatever it is. Learn how to play a musical instrument. Learn how to sing. Even if you are just going to sing in your bathroom, doesn't matter. So learning a new skill will increase competence, and that will have a roundabout and positive impact on your confidence as well. which now brings us to the third and most important, the fuel here. This one, the fuel that will, the rocket fuel that you put in to rise your confidence and competence to a whole new level, right up there, and stay and help you stay there, is this one, which is courage. And courage is not the absence of fear. Courage is the ability to handle fear effectively. So fear is good. Sometimes, you know, because of fear, a lot of things have happened, a lot of inventions have happened because there was fear involved, and people want to go away from fear, solve the fear, and probably sometimes I would say it's good to have fear. It's not the absence of fear, it's the ability to face the fear. That is what courage is all about. And there's one question that you can ask yourself every day that will help you have more courage in everything that you do, and that is, am I expressing my thoughts openly and clearly? Courage is not about, you know, going and jumping off a building on a parachute. Of course, skydiving, it takes a lot of courage. I did skydiving too. That is something. If you want to get more competence, if you want to learn something new, go do skydiving as well. But courage in this context is asking this question, am I expressing my thoughts openly? Because it so happens, even in leadership positions, there are so many instances where leaders were not able to lead properly because they did not express what they had in mind. They did not express their vision properly. They did not express their thoughts properly. Sometimes they did not express to their juniors or subordinates or colleagues, to their teammates, they did not express what they had to express. Sometimes even firing people. If someone is detrimental to the organization or the team, some leaders, because they consider themselves as, you know, great people, and sometimes you know, everybody has a little bit of narcissism associated with them, and they think they are such a good people. Oh, I am so good. People see me as such a good person. I cannot fire this guy. Let him or let her be just be there on the team. That is going to hurt in the long term. So if you are having something within you that needs to be expressed, courage is what it takes to express that. And here's one habit that will help you increase your levels of courage every day in your leadership position, and that is, do one bold activity. Do one bold activity. Like I said before, doing a courageous act like jumping off an airplane, using a, let's say, skydiving, for example, if you are about that, do that. If you are about scuba diving, do that. Choose, make a list of all the bold things that you think you want to do, go do it, and that will increase your courage. If you are, you know, if you are having fear of heights, skydiving is the best, you know, best method to cure you of the fear of heights. If you are fearing, if you have the fear of, let's say, drowning, you don't know how to swim, you fear that you will drown, go take scuba lessons. Diving lessons, that will get rid of. And there are some people who are, you know, I've seen in some seminars, especially in the eastern side, there are some seminars where people are losing their fears, getting rid of the fears of snakes by handling snakes. Like the seminar leader gives you a bunch of snakes to pet, if that's what you want to call it. So you handle a few snakes. I was having the fear, I still have. I've never had an opportunity to touch a snake, but next time I want to do that. That's one bold activity that I would do in order to cure myself the fear of snakes. Probably that will also help me gain more courage. So here are a few questions to ask every day. Make this list of questions, ask every day, and also follow these three habits to your already existing habits, so that you have higher levels of courage, higher levels of competence, and higher levels of confidence. All the three of them, all this, the entire framework, I just did it for you so that you can have higher levels of performance and productivity and growth. And let's meet again some other time in another video. Until then, keep smiling, believe in yourself, and get all the best things in life and higher levels of confidence, competence, and courage. Thank you.